My full name is Matthew Bunk, and my last name, you can spell it B-U-N-K. And my title here is editor at the Missoulian.
All right. So tell me, now you have just arrived. I understand this is your first day. Tell me how you got involved with the folks at the Missoulian. Are you a Lee Newspapers vet?
You know, I have worked for Lee Newspapers in the past, but that's not how I found out about this job opening. I actually had some friends within Lee, some very good journalists within Lee that had sort of pointed me towards this opportunity. And so I just made a call, talked to Mark, and we got the ball rolling from there.
Now, how long has this process taken, Matt?
Man, you know, it's probably, you know, I think probably from the beginning to the end, it probably took about 2 months.
Okay. Now, what was it that draws you? First of all, where are you from, and what brought you to Missoula?
Absolutely. I'm originally from Bismarck, North Dakota, but I spent the last 3 years, most recently the last 3 years, were in Libby, Montana, working for the Western News. I was the publisher for that newspaper.
You are a hardy soul, aren't you?
Yeah, you have to be, right, to live in Libby?
Yeah. Now, obviously, Libby has gone through its own transformation over the last several years with all the problems with the vermiculite and asbestos, and, of course, Senator Baucus coming in and helping the EPA to basically revitalize the town. So when you thought about coming to Missoula, what was it that drew you here?
Well, first of all, you know, the city itself is awesome. You know, I've had the opportunity to come down here and visit and spend some time doing some shopping on the weekends and other things like that. So I've always liked Missoula. It's just a great place. And then, you know, the paper itself, being able to work with a staff of people that, you know, a bunch of veterans on this staff, some really good journalists. And, you know, I just like the paper. It's just a very good paper and very solid, good news. And, you know, in this day and age, what's kind of unique about the Missoulian is that for a mid-sized or big daily paper, I guess, however you look at it, you know, we're able to do some really aggressive projects and do some really cool in-depth investigations. And that's really my forte. That's why I got into this business. I love watchdog journalism, and this newspaper does a good job of that, and I just wanted to be a part of it.
All right. Well, now, Matt, do you have any sort of I was just going to ask you, going from that, do you have an editorial style?
You know, I haven't really ever defined or thought about what my editorial style would be, but I guess, you know, I got into this business. The reason I got into this business is that I feel like it's very important to hold people accountable, government leaders accountable to the public that they serve, and that was probably my motivation at the beginning, and I think probably it's still some of my motivation today. It's just such a huge, awesome responsibility that we have as journalists, and you know, that watchdog aspect of what we do just excites me, and that's why I get out of bed every day.
Now, for those who aren't real familiar with newspapers or the professional journalism, what exactly does the lead editor do?
Yeah, it's well, other than just sort of sitting in the big corner office and twiddling my thumbs, I actually have quite a few duties. It's you know, being my first day, I've been pretty busy here, just doing this sort of, you know, the stuff that you would normally expect, you know, getting the network, you know, all set up and all that jazz. But you know, my daily duties from this point forward, I'm also the editor of the Revali Republic, so you know, there's a lot of stories to read, a lot of content that it needs to be edited, so I'll help in those areas. But mainly, I think my expertise is going to come in where, you know, on the assigning stories and the sort of the content, just sort of guiding the content. That's the big part of it, is just the planning, talking with reporters, hashing out ideas, and bringing it all together. So, you know, it's a little bit of everything. We got social media that takes up a lot of, we have a lot of followers, and it's something that we want to make sure that we're staying on top of. So that's part of my duties, is overseeing our social media networks. And we're also, you know, as you know, we publish daily on our website. You know, we're updated almost every hour with new stuff. And so that's also a big part of my duties, is overseeing the content there too. So I'm sure there's a whole lot more about the job that I'll learn about in the next few weeks. But, you know, content production and editing is going to be the main two things that I'm going to be doing here.
So you have a fine staff of reporters there at the Missoulian, and I was wondering how you plan on helping to develop that staff.
Well, like you said, a lot of the folks here have been around for quite a while, and they know the name of the game. For me, it's just a matter of, you know, fine-tuning some things. And, you know, it's beautiful on my end of things because I don't have to go back and teach people the basics or the fundamentals. It's something where we can focus on the high-level things and really just tweaking what's already working. So for me, it's going to be just largely getting these guys to do their best work and making sure that they're doing it every day.
Right. All right. Anything else that you'd like our listening public to know? Because I think probably a good portion of the folks who listen to our radio station also read the Missoulian. So a message from the new editor, Matt Bunk.
Well, I hope that, you know, the readers over the next few weeks and months are going to see some positive changes. And, you know, I'm looking forward to being a part of this. And it's an exciting time in this industry at this in this era. You know, there's so many changes, and what we do 1 week changes from, you know, compared to what we're going to do the next week. So, you know, just stay tuned and keep watching. There's going to be some cool things that were happening. And especially online, you're going to see some innovative products being launched.